Good morning, guys. It's Thursday, I think, and we're gonna get ham on. Cause when I planned the menu, it was like 60 degrees, and today it's supposed to be like 88 degrees. So ham dinner does not sound good. So backup plan, we're gonna throw it in the crock pot, so I don't have to have the oven on later on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw about a little bit of brown sugar on the bottom of the crock pot, a little bit of brown sugar on the top of the ham, and I'll show you what that looks like. So since I have one hand here, it's probably about an eighth of a cup of brown sugar. Alfonso's not much of a sweet meat person, so I don't want to put too much of this on, but just to get a nice glaze on it. I have it on low. And we're going to keep it in there for 8 hours. See what it looks like at the end of the day. Hey guys, today I'm having a day where I just am putting one foot in front of the other. I'm so slow going. I think that's going to be my motto today. One foot in front of the other. It was one of those days where I actually bought $1 million coffee. That's what kind of day it is today. Fingers. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Amen. Yes, you can. Go ahead.
Some very good friends of ours that are kind of like grandparents to Damien. Brought Damien over a birthday cake, and now we're gonna go outside and do some gardening. They brought us over a whole bunch of plants, so let's go see. Right on top of the flower. I got you. There you go. So I have it sitting over here, and then we're going to squeeze all the water out, and I'll show you that stuff in a minute. As you can see, the water is draining already off of those potatoes. I've got the ham cut here, probably a cup, a little bit, a generous cup. I've got 8 eggs in here, and roughly, you know, a tablespoon of milk, half a teaspoon of salt, quarter teaspoon of pepper. I'm just gonna go ahead and whisk this up. And so this recipe, you can use any type of meat. If you want meat, if you don't want meat, sausage, bacon, whatever leftover meat you want. You could even use chicken if you wanted to. But some of the cups, I'm gonna throw some green peppers and onion in. Some I'm not, for Damien. You could use spinach, you could use broccoli, you could use whatever you have on hand. I found some cheese on sale a couple weeks ago. This was in the freezer. Yes, you can freeze cheese. Check it out. So I'm going to sprinkle some of that on top. Some of you may know that I took dairy out. I'm going to squeeze this while I'm talking. Okay. I took dairy out of my diet for Lily, and I'm slowly
just putting little bits back in my diet. See what happens with Lily. See if her diet has, or her stomach has matured enough for it. So I'll put cheese on most of these. And then obviously the little bit of milk that's in the, look at all that water that's coming out. And that's, so now you have really good hash brown. So I mean, if that's how you wanted to make hash browns at home, that's how you're gonna get nice and crispy hash browns when you make them. So to a well-oiled pan, after I squeezed out as much water as I could, I distributed evenly the potatoes into each spot. So it roughly was about 1 tablespoon for each spot. Half of them I'm gonna put the garlic or the onion and green peppers. Half I'm not. I'm gonna do about the same for the green for the ham. Just distribute it evenly in between each one here. I'm thinking we're gonna do about a tablespoon of meat in each. Maybe a little bit more in the ones that don't have the veggies. And then I'm gonna get the egg on top. After that. So here we go. As you can see here, I can't give you a measurement on how much egg to put in each one because that depends on how much veggies and how much ham you put in each one. Or if you don't want to use potatoes, you don't have to. This is just, you know, a recipe that's really, you can put anything you want in. These are going to puff up. You don't want to put it all the way to the top, so you want to get about 3/4 full. You know, just a little bit of space. We're going to top this with some cheese. They did a whole bunch of work with Alfonso, but mostly them, because I was with the kiddos, and, but Alfonso had already made this path up to here, so all the way coming up this way. Now, this is what they did yesterday, so we have another step here, and then got these rocks here. I've never been able to come up here before because I was either pregnant, holding a baby, or both. So they gave us some hostas and some praying hands, I think it's called, and some other things that I don't remember their names, but there's like this little triangle. There's another hosta there. I don't remember what these are called. So there's like this triangle here. And we go up this way. They spent like 5 hours here doing this for us yesterday. It was just amazing. This is the most amazing couple. They flattened out this spot, cut down some of this, oh gosh, I forget what it's called, but it's like a tree, but it has a whole bunch of thorns on it. I forget what it's called. But then we arrive to Mama Mary. So they planted some of these. I forget what they're called, but once these grow, got some over here, and then these will grow down this little hill here. The same with those that grow down the little hill. They'll be just beautiful. So today it's going to get to like 90 degrees, so I'll have to come up here and water them. But we have this nice little spot that I can now come up and get up to, and we have this nice little area that we can bring flowers to when we want to come see our lady. So, just let you listen to the nature here. There's the path down. Hi, Damien! There's our hammock. Here's our There's the top view from those beautiful flowers. I'm just... There are certain people in your life that teach you how you want to be, how you want to live in your life. This couple is one of them that has been a good mentor for Alfonso and I. And like I said, they're like adopted grandparents to Damien. So I'm going to take you back down because I got to go check on those eggs. You can see those have puffed up. So we have about 16 minutes going on these right now. So I'm going to give them about 3 more minutes and check them. Because the middle is not quite done yet. This is what they look like just out of the oven. This was probably 90 cents to a dollar for the whole thing. So if you're going to have, you know, one or two for breakfast. It's a super, super duper frugal breakfast. We're just gonna throw it together. I have some yogurt mixed with fruit over here for Damien and I. We're gonna have this for lunch. Buen provecho.
Is
that very good? You like it?
Yeah.
Good. Buen provecho, Damien.